Hey friends, welcome back to Crusty Cranks. All right, we're going to do a little bait here. This is for somebody sent me an email wanting me to paint this bait. It's called the Elegy Bone by Megabass. And normally I only do baits that I can sell. And I won't be selling any of these because this is pretty much just a knockoff of it. And but he wanted to see what it looked like when I painted it. I know a couple other people's already painted it, so I didn't want to throw it up right away as soon as they painted it, so kind of give a little time. But yeah, I'm gonna show you how I would paint it. And so I showed you the colors at the beginning, but we'll go over them as we go through. And first color we're going to load up is fluorescent yellow. So you might want to paint one of these for yourself or a couple of them, whatever. But like I said, I normally only like to paint baits that I can sell, and I won't be selling this. But it's got some pretty cool techniques to it to get it done. All right, so we're not doing any white. We're starting off with the clear bait, and I've cleaned it off with alcohol, rubbing alcohol. Got it real nice and clean because I'm not putting a base on it. So we're going to take this chartreuse, and we're just going to hit the bottom real light. And you're going to have to paint this on light because you don't want it to start running on you. And I really don't want to try to cover the whole thing in one coat. So we're just going to do some light coats and we'll dry it. And we'll put a couple coats on it. And I'm staying right on the bottom. I actually got to see one of these actual baits because one of my buddies, the fishes in tournaments, he actually had one. I was telling him that I was going to paint one for somebody, a customer or a subscriber wanted to see one, so he was like, oh, I actually have that bait. So I got a chance to look at it, and it's pretty cool because the light actually goes through it when you look at it. Once I get this chartreuse on it, you'll be able to see that the light actually goes through and almost looks like it's painted all the way up, if that makes sense. But we're just trying to stay right on the bottom. If we get a little drift up the top, that's towards the sides, that's okay. But we're gonna get it pretty well covered on the bottom here. Sorry about the hair dryer. I know a lot of people don't like to hear that. But I'm just trying to get a nice coat on here without running. It's really actually an easy bait to paint. All right, I think that's gonna do it. I'm gonna give it a real good dry and then I'll get the next color in the brush. Okay, next we're going with just the straight opaque black. And the same thing, we're gonna layer it on there real nice and light. And we wanna just come down the sides a little bit. Just break the shoulders. Down this side just a little bit more. Okay, we're gonna hit the face and the eyes, and we're gonna keep our black in there because once we put the color shift on, we're gonna come back and darken the face back up a little bit more. Then break that up just on the shoulder a little bit deeper right here. That's it. All right, I'm gonna dry this real good, and then next we'll be doing the Vallejo violet, electric blue, and violet color shift. Okay, next we're going with the Vallejo, the electric blue, intense violet, and that was the last of my bottle, so we're gonna try to get this bait out of it. I think you got enough in here. I'm gonna squeeze it out, I think. Got lucky. Coat that baby real good. So you get that blue effect. I think we got lucky. Might as well use the rest of it. Like I always say, this stuff's like Frank's Red Hot Sauce. Put this shit on everything. I know there's a lot of color shifts out there, and you guys can, you know, chime in which color shifts you use, what you like to use. I like the Vallejo. There's a lot of different colors in there, but the thing I like about it is I know what I'm going to get out of it, just like that. I've never painted this bait before, but I knew that I could put that black on there and get that blue that looks just like that Elegy bone. So, we're going to blacken in the eye a little bit, and I'm going to dry this real good, and then we're going to put our stencil on there. And on the stencil that we're going to be doing is going to be a transparent white. And if you don't have no transparent white, you can really, you can thin your white down. But when I looked at the bait that he had, you could see through the white. So you could see through that. And I think that's what makes this bait so effective, is that when the light shines through it, you know, you get those greens at the bottoms and those blue, purple, violet colors at the top. And I think that's just what makes it so effective, is because the colors go through. When you put your yellow on there, you're going to think you spread it up here, because the way it looks when you look at it from the top, I should have showed you that. I don't know if you could see it on camera, but when I sprayed it, I almost thought, wow, I got the yellow, the chartreuse, all the way up to the top, but I didn't. Because when I looked at it close, I could tell that the yellow wasn't on the top. It was just shining the light through there, which is another reason why you don't really, I don't think, you know, they put the white on the bottom to bring that yellow out, because then it kills that reflection of that light going up through that green, through that, or through that chartreuse yellow. But I don't know. That's just my opinion. But yeah, so let me dry this real good, and I'll put a little black on the eye. And we'll put a little tint of black on the back, and we'll be ready for the white. Okay, so we had the black in there. What we're going to do now is just hit this eye just a little bit, real close. It does have just a little spot of black on the eye. Okay, and then right down the back, couple little swipes just to deepen that up on the backside. You don't want to kill your blue. good enough. There it is. Let's put the white on it and we'll have her done. All right, you can dry this, clean this brush out, and we'll be right back. Okay, got me some stencil here, and it's not exactly like the algae bone because I didn't want a dead copy everything on it, so I kind of made up my own little stencil pattern here as it kind of gets fat and then fades to the tail. So yeah, I think this will work fine. And again, we're painting this with transparent white, so it might be a little hard to see. And I'm gonna have to pull this off camera just to get it on in position. Okay, I got the stencil on there. Let's see how this looks. Like I said, I haven't painted one of these before, so I don't know. But we got some transparent white in there. Which is kind of hard to see, but we're going to give it a shot. Oh, worked out perfect. There we go. I don't know if you can see that on camera or not, but you will when we put the epoxy on it. Got it a little higher than I wanted, but hey, it looks good. Like I said, it's not a dead match. I'm not trying to steal their pattern. I'm just trying to show somebody that wants to paint their own. You can always buy them too. Let's get the other side on there. That one turned out nice. That side turned out good. All right, let's get some eyes on it. Okay, let's get some eyes on this guy. Closest ones I could find that kind of resembled the algae bone is this one right here. So we're gonna stick that one on there. We're going with that one. The only difference is the eyes are looking down and it's a little bit darker, but let's stick these guys on here. Get some epoxy on it. I'll show you the other one I did for TikTok. If you're on TikTok, go look us up. We're getting ready to start uploading some videos on there, some shorts. TikTok videos and shorts on YouTube. So, yeah, give us a like and subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, please. Really help us. We're getting close. We want to get to 2,000. That's our barrier for right now. Is our goal is to get to 2,000. All right. There it is. It turned out pretty decent. Like I said, I probably need to throw that white away. Throw all them U.S. Art Supply paints away. They're kind of flaky. That one was... Here's the other one. That one was a little runny, but all right, let's get some epoxy on these guys. All right, guys, here we are. Here's the finished algae bone. Looking pretty good. I thought I'd bring it outside here before it got dark and
let you see the colors. Looks better in the evening than when I do it in the bright light of sunlight. But yeah, so Mike, Bandit VA, shoot me an email with your address and I'll send you one of these. Sorry, I'm keeping one of them. But yeah, if you want to paint one of these, colors we used, chartreuse yellow by Createx. Then we used some opaque black on the back, covered that with some Vallejo electric blue intense violet. And then we put our little bone pattern on there with the transparent white. And yeah, turned out really good. This looking dynamite, especially with the light going through it. You can see that transparency. Looks pretty cool. So, but I appreciate all you guys are subscribing and hitting that like button, sending emails. I love seeing your guys' lures when you paint them. Send me an email. It's pretty cool. We're building a pretty nice little community of people here. So if you want to trade a lure, hit me up. I'll trade a lure with you. Give me one of your patterns. I'll do one for you. And yeah, let's trade a lure. But once again, I appreciate everybody that subscribed to the channel. If you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button, ring that notification bell, and give us a thumbs up, and we'll keep on doing these kind of videos. I got some more coming up for you guys. Winter's coming on us. Won't be doing much fishing, but we'll be doing some bait making. So appreciate it, and always remember, stay crusty, my friends.